This match, one fall, introducing first of all, making his debut here at Grand Slam USA for the National Wrestling Federation, hailing from Daytona Beach, Florida, 255 pounds, the Equalizer! And his opponent, no stranger to these rings, from Columbia, Tennessee, 195 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, Danny Pig, one fall.
Yeah!
Rockies Folk Wrestling Alliance, the FWA. Tony Falk's Uncle Freddy has given me a lot of money, at least $25,000 to start out. I'm going to be buying some wrestlers' contracts. We are going to build the Falk Wrestling Alliance into the incredible dynasty that it can be. And these guys are going to have an empty dressing room because we're going to have all the contracts we want, and the rest of them are going to be out of business. This match scheduled for one fall. We're going to see, first of all, accompanied to the ring by his manager, Catwoman Taylor. I'm sorry, I looked at the paper wrong. Cat Taylor. I'm sorry. Actually, his brothers are that birth control pill. 247 pounds, he's the legend, Tony Falk. And his opponent, 180 pounds, from Delray, Mexico, the Blue Cyclone. One fall. Let's go! 5 minutes.
Thank you.
more of a statement. This is supposed to be a handicap match, supposed to be your man and the Nazi terror. I believe I don't see the Nazi terror anywhere. And it's, you know, and the way it works, I believe, the Nazi terror is not here.
Right, the Nazi terror was in an unfortunate car wreck. So we're gonna have, I mean, originally this was kind of stacked, you know, even, because it's like we had a handicap match, and if King could win, then I would wrestle him for 5 minutes. But since the Nazi terror is not here, the way I see it, yeah, we need to take off the five minutes for me part.
And I tell you, it's really only fair that if it is not a handicap match in the sense that it was going to be, that he don't get whipped at the end. The main reason being that you're going to be in the match. You're going to be the extra man. Yeah, get a little bit out there. Yeah, no, your partner right here. That's your partner. It is a handicap.
I'm not dressed to wrestle. You people are always making fun of me. I saw those signs on the door that said Super Pee Wee Basketball. That's making fun of me, isn't it?
Well, I thought about it. Yeah, it is, Pee-wee. Get into the ring. Get in the ring. So, yeah, you talked yourself into a corner, Pee-wee.
Thank you.
gone. 5 minutes.
Faggots
Pac-Man for a minute there. No, I don't want any ferret fox. No, sir. I think... I would apologize, but there's nothing I can do about it.
This man, you're a graduate of Fort Bank Academy. You know I'm talking to you. Listen, I know I got friends, and if I need them, they're there. But see, I don't need them from you two punks. Hey, listen. The night after Halloween, we're back here, right? We don't need no kind of stupid button match. All we need is me against you two one more time. Hey, and I'm going to bring me a friend. You might call him Freddy Monster, the Boogie Woogie Man, or whatever, but I'm going to have me a friend, baby. And he's going to stand right out here. And Tony Falk, you stick your nose. You and your little fag buddy stick your nose in my business again. I'm going to chop it off.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, hey. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'll sign a contract against Stone Spring. And if anybody else has got the guts to put their name on there, namely you, Tony Falker, you little fag buddy, sign it. We'll go 3-on-4. I don't care.
And I'll take him out. I'll
have to
you out against him.
That'd be really good, wouldn't it? The entire dressing room against one man. That's good there, Pee-wee. I mean, Cat. Goodness. Yeah, we'll get that match signed. Man, we're going to take a short break, fans. Visit our friends over here, the wrestlers who have their concessions with them, their t-shirts, caps, and so forth. Go to the concession stand, get a good cold drink.
Thank you.
2 weeks ago.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago, we said we'd bring Susan out. Hand cover to this.
Well, I'm not going to say.
Hey, we got a real lady.
Yeah, that's right. We got a real lady. Hey, everybody, everybody in Columbia knows that if we handcuff Susan to her, there ain't no way she'll get in that ring. And if she does, Susan will kick her.
Two weeks ago, you made that match and implicated Susan in the match.
No more.
We found out since then that she doesn't have a manager's license, she has no valet's license, and the insurance, because of that, will not allow her to be at ringside. I can't do anything about it. I'm sorry. That's what I was told by Mr. Pig here. He was told by the commission. And that's how I'm going to do it. Shane, I don't want any problem here.
If you're scared, all you gotta do is just say, hey, we're scared. You don't have to go to the commission and say, we can't get no more out of the ringside. Hey, I'm talking about this much Mountain Dew and I'm fired up, brother. Woo!
Since you don't have a license and she cannot be out here ringside, they can't bring somebody out here if they do have a license. You got somebody that'll be out here, Jane, that has a license.
Hey, listen, Ben, y'all. They got one over on you. But listen. You gotta be a licensed wrestler or manager or something like that, right? Hey, James, come here a minute. James, he's a licensed wrestler. He's an up-and-coming wrestler. James, come here, brother. He's got a wrestling license. Hey, this guy's going through wrestling school. He's got a wrestling license already. He's got a license. Hey, boo! It's like this. When I was growing up, I was always taught not to hit a woman. But she's not a woman, so you can do whatever you want to do, brother.
How can I concentrate on what I'm doing if I'm concentrating on this bum out here trying to do something to my woman?
We don't know their health cards correct. He will not do anything if she doesn't do anything. And I'm sorry, I don't have the young man's name. Introducing first of all, from Dallas, Texas, weighing in 247 pounds, he's the legend, Tony Ball. And from San Francisco, California, Slim Trim, 299 pounds, he's every man's dream, every woman's nightmare, first of all, from Phoenix, Arizona, 237 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, Wild Boy Ben Jordan. And his partner from New York City, 200 pounds, he's the Boogie Woogie Boy, Gary Zion.
Oh,
5 minutes gone. 5 minutes. a foul in the match. Cody Falk and Baron Barr. The winner, Baron Fox and Tony Ball. The win by disqualification. Bill, what was he thinking?
A bit unusual for Tony Falk to run his mouth. No. Everybody's seen, I don't have to come out here and repeat it every time. Everybody's seen what happened. Yeah. And yeah, I was trying to beat your damn brains out. You brought it, I'm using it. Hey, Ferg! Come on out here. You like this, wouldn't you, brother?
Almost jerked this little woman or big woman's arm off. That's right, Tony. I was just doing my job. Next time it'll be your head.
Looks like I gotta do everything around here. I can't wait for Dante, my man. I'm so sick of all the crap.
Everybody
I'm sick of
these guys.
Not everybody's a professional. He will be back sooner than you think. I'm betting on everything I own. Looks like I gotta do all the talking, all this. I gotta just, the FWA is gonna take over and I'm gonna run the whole show. I'm gonna be the booker, the promoter, everything, because nothing gets done if I, okay, you see the side fern? Go get your fern, honey. Listen up.
Honey,
listen up.
Look, honey.
2 weeks from tonight, this is what you wanted. I can read your mind because I know you was gonna say this thing, Jordan. You was gonna say something like this. Tony Falk and Fern, I'm sick and tired of you two sissy boys coming in here thinking you can beat us. So you're gonna sit here and tell these people that 2 weeks from tonight, you want a match with us. You don't want nobody interfering.
You want the girl banned from ringside. Where's that stupid? We're gonna, and I'm going to say this much. If you want a match like that, you can have a match under one condition. And if we beat either one of y'all for the three count, 1, 2, 3, you will split up the team. You will not be able to wrestle for 6 months as a tag team. You call yourself the, that's what I was going to say to you. Now, what you going to say to me?
It's like this. Who is thinking up this stuff? Look, you just come out here and say you want this match. You want that? Yeah, we will take you on in 2 weeks. I'll tell you what, and just because you brought it up, because you're always bringing everything up, you're always running that mouth. Just because you bring it up, yeah, we'll take that, because these people know who will win. Yeah. Hey, we'll split up for six months, all right, as a tag team, all right? But if y'all get beat, we get the whooping girl. Listen. Whip the belt. And plus, y'all can't go home together for 6 months.
Tony Falk, in 2 weeks, if you people win the match, they split up for 6 months. But if they win, they get to whip your lady.
She ain't a lady.
I'm sorry.
She's a foot.
With a belt. Fans, you want to see something like that?
I'll whoop her for you with no charge.
She looks like a butch.
She looks like a fucking dog.
Hey, we'll take just a couple of minutes to reconstruct the ring. Visit the concessions over here, the gentlemen that have their pictures and so forth. I think I've got 3 or 4 tickets left here to whip. 5 tickets left to whip Cat Pamela's cat. And if you want one of the new Pro Wrestling Illustrated magazines, got those here. They come out in January. Just $2. Back in about 5 or 10 minutes, we'll get this ring picked up.
Let me see.
Huh? Oh,
Thank you. Oh, get over it.
Give me the keys.
slowness. They're trying to keep the ring from falling down. You know, I'll need Mars to help you. She'll fix it for you.
Yeah.
Shane Morton.
Lucifer and whoever that goofish you got with you. I ain't been around here in 3 years. This is the first time I've been in the wrestling ring in 3 years, brother. I ain't been in the ring 3 years. When you pinned my shoulders, what did you do? You want to pin somebody, you pin one of these men right here, and then you can celebrate. Because as of right now, you ain't done nothing. Hey, Mr. Matchmaker, you're the one in control here, man. Hey, keep him back. Hey, you're the one in control here, buddy. Showed you we can beat their brains out. And everyone who's coming tonight, they had to pin somebody, a good friend of mine with just a little bit of ring rust. That's all they can do, buddy. 7 days, sign it, Tennessee Street Fight, put the powers up. We'll come back here to Columbia the champion.
2 weeks from tonight.
Hey, let me get this straight. You just said we beat nobody because you got a little ring rust for us to beat one of them two? I tell you what, either three of you get your ass in the ring and we'll still beat your ass. Hey, just put the titles up, man. We don't know who that is, man. You people, shut up. Principal, you come in here. Hey, good old boy, good old man. Put your girlfriend in the hand, baby. And you ask anybody around here. And let me tell you, you come back and we're going to beat you to death, boys. Put the titles on the line.
You've got a street fight in Lewisburg. 2 weeks, the titles will be on the line. You'll get your wins, but you've got 2 weeks right here. Right here. Next week, you're going to be in Lewisburg. You better be able to come back next week.
Hey, no six-man, just a tag team match.
Tag team, that's right, for the match. In 2 weeks, right here, November 1st, right here. Next week, street fight in Lewisburg. 2 weeks, title fight here.
Hey, next week, Lewisburg, we're going to beat you down. And if you're able to make it back here to Columbia in 2 weeks, we're taking home the belt.
Hey, hold on. I'm just going to make it short and sweet and simple to you, brother. And then I got something a little bit more serious on my mind. But these people don't know what's going on. But Hot Rod, it's 3-0, brother. Why don't you just give up? Just give up.
Tell him, baby.
Now, I got something to say to the FWL, TWL, but where I'm from, I just call it plain damn old queer. So let me tell you something. Tony Falk, I got a phone call last Sunday, brother, where you were bad-mouthing me and Boone Hill. Well, let me tell you something. You don't like the way I do things. You don't like the way Nathan does things. Why don't you come out here and be a man and show me what you're all about? See, I don't carry a knife. I don't carry a gun. Because I do it with my damn hands, and I will wear your fat ass out. And I don't care if you've been in the business 14 years, 21 years. You ain't no better today than you was when you started, punk. So don't sit back there. Don't sit back there in the dressing room. Be a man. This is not Boone Hill, brother. Lucifer's right here in person, punk. And you can take, hey, Cat Taylor, I don't know who you are, boy. But Elvis died 20 years ago with that damn haircut. And let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. I was filling this place up 7 or 8 years ago before you boys even came into town. So let me tell you something. One last thing, Tony Falk. Sit back here and be a chicken and do me a favor. Call Dante tomorrow and tell him what Lucifer's doing. Because I got news for you. I don't give a damn what he thinks anymore. Willie Paul! Willie Paul! You can fire me tonight. I don't care. I don't care where you at, you bald-headed geek. I'm telling you now that I'm a man, Tony Falk, and this boy behind me's a man. And I see where you're coming from because you're sitting back there on your butt. So that just proves to me you're all mouth and no damn ass.
Contestant will be Lucifer. I'm sorry, Lucifer left, okay? thank you folks for being here with us on this Saturday night. Join us next Saturday night in Lewisburg, Tennessee, back here on November 1st with our big Murray County King of the Ring Challenge match. We'll see you then. See you next Saturday night. Good night, everybody.
Thank you.